This is Pastor Byron from Life Point Church in Lexington, North Carolina. What's in a word? We find in verses 1 and 2 of the prophet Isaiah, chapter 61, these words. He has sent me to bind up the brokenhearted, to proclaim freedom for the captives, to release from darkness for the prisoners, to proclaim the year of the Lord's favor and the day of vengeance of our God. He is talking about Jesus, the Son of God. He was prophesying that he was going to come. We know that he did come, lived 33 and a half years, was crucified, buried, and on the third day arose again. What's in a word? In the Jewish language, we must always remember that their alphabet is one of imagery. That means that the words, the characters, there are pictures with the characters and with the words themselves. So we look at this and God is promising to believers his favor. What are the pictures of the word that he's saying? He actually has two pictures there. He has the picture of a house or a hut. And he also has a picture of the source of food, a fish. Synonymous with nutrition, synonymous with something that gives life. We put these two word pictures or characters together, and we learn that God is promising to us that he is going to provide our shelter. He is going to provide our sustenance. In other words, God is saying, I want to give to you my favor. I want you to be able to walk in the blessings that I have already prepared for you. Here's my promise to you. If you will do this, if you will focus on me, if you will seek me first, I promise to protect you. I promise to shield you. I promise to provide for you. I promise to provide all the resources, all of the food, all the nutrition that you need for life. That's a beautiful image. God making those promises to you. You say, well, Byron, but we're in the midst of a pandemic. We're in the midst of COVID-19. We are. I can assure you that has not caught God off guard. I can give you promise that God did not know that it was going to happen. It wasn't that God woke up one day like the rest of us and, oh my, it's here. No. God knew. God knew where we would be today, Thursday, July the 23rd. And God said, here's my promise for you. I'm still promising favor. I'm still promising blessings. I'm still promising protection. But my promise is conditional, as all of God's promises to believers are conditional. The only promise that God makes that is unconditional is the promise of salvation. For God so loved the world that he gave his only Son, that if you will believe on him, there's a condition. You believe in him. You invite him into your heart. He says, I will give to you eternal life. You do your part, and I will do mine. But it applies to everybody. There's no condition. But you make the choice. But all the other promises are conditional. This promise of God's favor is conditional. He said, you persevere in seeking me first. You continue moving forward with the most important thing in your life, to spend time with me, to keep me first, and I promise you that you will overcome. I promise you there are going to be better days ahead. There are going to be brighter times ahead. That's my promise to you. I promise to you this too shall pass. You walk through the valley, but don't miss the words, walk through. We're not living in the valley forever. We're only here for a short period of time. God said, I'll have you through the valley and on the other side. I have all manner of promises, all manner of blessings, favor that I want to give to you. But right now it's tough. But don't give up hope. Don't lose sight of who is in control. I promise you that I will give to you favor that is beyond your expectations. I promise you that to surround you with blessings that are greater than anything you can even imagine. God is saying, keep the faith. Don't give up hope. Don't get lost in all the negativity and all the bickering and all the turmoil that seems to just overabound in our lives right now. Don't lose sight of hope. Don't lose sight of me. Acknowledge to yourself and encourage others to believe and trust in the goodness of God, in the blessing of God, in the favor of God. God said, all I need for you to do is seek me first. Keep me first in your life. Keep me first in your minds, in your thoughts. Spend time with me. Let me be the positive in your life. And I will give to you the shelter. I will give to you the protection. I will give to you the sustenance, the nutrition that you need to live life. Will you pray with me right now? Father, thank you for your promise of boundless protection. Thank you for the provisions that you have promised to pour into our lives. God, we need you more right now than we've ever needed you in our life. But the good news about that is you're here. You're available right now. You have the promises. You have the imagery that we need to stay encouraged, to remain full of hope, and to share that courage and that hope with others. Thank you, God, for your favor that you are bestowing on those who are walking close with you. I am encouraged, O God. Amen.